Hi everyone, my name is Pranav Kole and I am back with another video on probability on the behalf of Tutor here. In the previous video, we saw that if we throw a die once, the probability of getting a number greater than 4, which is denoted by E, is 1 by 3, and the probability of getting a number less than or equal to 4, which was denoted by F, is 2 by 3. So here we can note that getting a number not greater than 4 is same as getting a number less than or equal to 4 and vice versa. So is F not the same as not E? Yes, it is. We denote P of not E by E bar. Not E means all the outcomes which are not in the set of E. So as we know that P of E plus P of F is equal to 1, as we saw in the previous video. Therefore, we can replace F by E bar. So the equation becomes P of E plus P of E bar is equal to 1. Therefore, P of E bar is equal to 1 minus P of E. P of E bar is also called as complement of event E. We can also say that E and E bar are complementary events. Let's look at an example to explain the previous concept. Two players A and B play a tennis match. It is known that the probability of A winning the match is 0.59. So what is the probability of B winning the match? Let E denote the event that A wins the match and F denote the event B wins the match. So the probability of A's winning P of E is equal to 0.59, which is already given in the question. So now the probability of B's winning can be calculated using the previous formula where P of E bar is equal to 1 minus P of E. Here, since there is no other outcome possible, it's either A wins the match or B wins the match. Therefore, E and F events are complementary. Therefore, P of F can be also written as 1 minus P of E. Therefore, P of F is equal to 1 minus 0.59, which is equal to 0.41. This is how you use complementary events in a question. So before proceeding further, let us try to find out the answer for the following question. What is the probability of getting a number 9 in a single throw of a die? Now, as we know that there are only 6 possible outcomes in a single throw of a die. These outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Since no face of a die is marked 9, therefore there is no outcome favorable to 9. That is, the number of such outcomes is 0. In other words, getting 9 in a single throw of a die is impossible. So, P of getting 9 is equal to 0 by 6, which is 0. Such events are called as impossible events. Let us try to find out the answer of another question. What is the probability of getting a number less than 7 in a single throw of a die? Now here, since every face of a die is marked with a number which is less than 7, therefore it is sure that we will always get a number less than 7 when we throw a die once. So the number of favorable outcomes is same as the number of total possible outcomes, which is 6. Therefore, P of E, which is P of getting a number less than 7, is 6 by 6 or 1. So, probability of an event which is sure or certain to occur is 1. Such events are known as sure events or certain events. So, from these two questions, we can say that the value of probability cannot be less than 0. Also, it cannot be more than 1. Therefore, the probability lies in the range of 0 to 1. So to summarize all the theoretical part that we saw in this video, total probability is always 1. P of not E or P of E bar is equal to 1 minus P of E. If probability of an event is 0, it is called an impossible event. And if it is 1, it is called a certain event. And finally, the range of any probability of any event lies from 0 to 1. Let's solve few questions. One card is drawn from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards. Calculate a probability that a card will be a king or would not be a king. So, well shuffling ensures equally likely outcomes. So, there are four kings in a deck. Let E be the event, the card is a king. So, the number of outcomes favorable to E are 4, and the number of possible outcomes are 52, since there are 52 cards in a deck. Therefore, P of E, that is P of getting a card which is a king, is 4 by 52 or 1 by 13. Now, let F be the event, card drawn is not a king. Number of possible outcomes are 52. And number of outcomes favorable to event F is 52 minus 4, which is equal to 48. Since E and F are complementary events in this case, and E has the possible outcomes of 4. Therefore, P of F is 48 divided by 52, which is 12 by 13. Now, what if I wanted a king of red color? As we saw in the previous question, probability of having a king is 1 by 13. But if we want a king of red color, the probability changes. Now, we all know that there are 4 kings in the deck. 2 are red and 2 are black. So, now E becomes the event that the card is a red king. Therefore, number of possible outcomes here are 2, since there are 2 red kings. And number of possible outcomes are 52, since there are 52 cards in the deck. Therefore, P of E now becomes 2 by 52, which is 1 by 26. Let's look at another example. A box contains 5 red marbles, 8 white marbles, and 4 green marbles. One marble is taken out of the box at random. What is the probability that the marble taken out would be a red, white, or not a green marble? Now, total number of balls here are 5 red, 8 white, and 4 green marbles, which is a total of 17. Now, if you remember the formula of probability, it is number of favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. Therefore, total number of red balls in this question are 5. Therefore, probability of getting a red ball is 5 by 17, which is 0.29. Similarly, probability of getting a white ball is 8 by 17, since we have 8 white balls, and the answer is 0.47. These are the simple questions which we also solved previously. Now, what is the probability that a marble taken out will be not green? For this, total number of green balls here are 4. Therefore, probability of getting a green ball is 4 by 17, which is 0.23. But we don't want a probability of getting a green ball. We want a probability of not getting a green ball. Therefore, now, if you remember, the complementary events, the sum of complementary events is 1. Therefore, probability of not getting a green ball is 1 minus probability of getting a green ball, which is 1 minus 4 by 17, which is 0.77. Thank you for watching this video. I hope you like it.